Last line, it was SI unit Newton per meter square Pascal. Only that much we have written.
Certain
Yes, certain dimension.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Have we written CGS unit?
Yes, sir.
What we have written CGS unit?
9 per centimeter square. Okay.
No, note right down. One atmospheric pressure is nothing but 760 millimeter height of mercury column. One atmospheric pressure is 760 millimeter height of mercury column. And one atmospheric pressure is 1.013 into 10 raised to 5 Newton per meter square. See, we can take one more unit is torr. One torr is nothing but 760 millimeter of mercury. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Torr is also a unit, which is called as 760 millimeter of mercury. Is also called one torr. Write this 3 points. One torr is actually 1 millimeter of mercury like this. One torr is 1 millimeter of mercury. So can you tell me one atmospheric pressure is how many torr? Torr matlab actually torricelli ek scientist ka naam. If one torr is 1 millimeter, so one atmosphere is how many torr? 760 760 torr. Millimeter matlab torr.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Please write this much. Only in some cases they can ask if they want to make paper difficult. If them tell me, I'm clearing and coming to the next
topic. Yes, sir. Then. Okay.
Derive expression for pressure due to derive expression for pressure due to liquid column. Consider a container containing liquid of density rho. Consider a column of liquid having height h. So at this column, there will be force acting due to weight of the liquid. Consider liquid of density rho to be taken in a container. Let H
be the height of liquid column having area of cross section rho. Please copy this much. Consider liquid of density rho to be taken in a container. Let H be the height of liquid column having area of cross section A. Okay, written?
Yes, sir.
Okay, 1 minute, wait. Now, since pressure equals to force upon area, so this will be weight upon area. Weight is mg, area is A. M is density into volume. Mass is density into volume, correct?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Volume, can I say area of base into height? A gets cancelled.
Yes.
This becomes H rho G. So pressure due to liquid column is H rho G. Copy? Is copied full?
Yes, sir. Then.
I'm just clearing it now. Now you just imagine if a person is floating at the top of the liquid surface. Now only pressure acting on him is atmospheric pressure, correct? No? Because he is at the top. When this person comes down at height h from the top, now what will be net pressure? At the top, pressure is only due to this air column, that is atmospheric pressure. Depth jab gaya to iske upar ye pressure प्लस ए हाइट ऑफ लिक्विड कॉलम के वजह से भी प्रेशर एक्ट होएगा. सो कैन आई से लाइक दिस, टोटल प्रेशर इज ऑलवेज सम ऑफ atmospheric pressure plus pressure due to height h. Pressure due to height h. Atmospheric pressure is Pa, due to height h is h rho g. So some numericals they can give you of this type. Find the total pressure. It is atmospheric plus h rho g. Copy this note.
None, sir.
Okay. State Pascal's law. State Pascal's law. If I take two cylinder fitted with one another horizontal cylinder, both side we have covered it. Inside there is liquid. Now this liquid is closed or open?
Sir, this liquid is closed.
When you apply pressure on one piston, this pressure will get transmitted to other piston.
Yes.
Such that pressure at first point is same as pressure at second point. So first pressure is transmitted equally to second point. This law is called Pascal's law. So Pascal's law states that pressure applied at any point on confined liquid, confined means closed liquid, is transmitted at any other point, is transmitted undiminished at any point in the liquid. So pressure applied at one point is transmitted at any other point undiminished. Undiminished means without any change. This is called Pascal's law. Hello? Understood Pascal's law?
Yes, sir. Understood.
Right. According to Pascal's law. According to Pascal's law. Pressure applied to enclosed liquid. Pressure applied to enclosed liquid is transmitted in all directions at any point in the liquid undiminished. Now we'll explain this.
Can you repeat the sentence?
It's written, can you see? Before this you have not written, then I will dictate. If you have written that, then you can see.
Please dictate. I misplaced.
Okay, no problem. Pressure applied at any point in enclosed liquid. Pressure applied at any point in enclosed liquid then here is transmitted in all direction at any point in the liquid undiminished.
Yes, sir.
Now I'm clearing this. Now suppose they ask, explain. One cylinder, another cylinder. This is one piston, another piston. Suppose on this piston pressure is P1, area is A1, so this piston pressure is P2, area. Please draw this diagram. Yes, diagram over.
Yes, sir.
So consider two cylinders filled with liquid and fitted with pistons of area of cross section A1, A2. According to Pascal's law, pressure applied at one point P1 is transmitted at other point P2. So force upon area is force upon area. That means F2 will be F1 into A2 upon A1. Hello?
Yes, sir.
So force acting on second case is F1 into A2 upon A1. So if denominator is large, this is A1, then force applied will be small. But if denominator is large, see, small. A2 is large, smaller here. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Just copy it. Fill this copy.
हाँ सर. हाँ नहीं लेक्चर है बोलिए. हाँ बोलो ना सर. हाँ 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 हाँ. आज कॉल करता हूँ मैं आपको शाम को. नहीं वो तो अपन उनको ये संडे का बोल देंगे ना सर, तो पूरा वीक का दे देंगे, हमको आज ही दे देंगे, बोलना पोस्ट कर देते हैं हम लोग पूरे आगे 2-3 महीने. हाँ 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 चलेगा चलेगा, मैं करता हूँ आपको पास.
completed?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now see, what is use of this Pascal's law in our day-to-day life? See, those who have either driven the vehicle or sat adjacent to some driver, he applies on the pedal brake, correct? और ब्रेक का जो एरिया रहता है बहुत ज्यादा
yes, रहता है
ब्रेक का जो एरिया रहता है वो ज्यादा होता है क्या छोटा होता है
छोटा होता है
छोटा होता है
छोटा होता है मतलब ये A1 छोटा है ना अपने लिए मेरे हिसाब से ये A1 छोटा है ना इधर उन मतलब पेडल के हिसाब से इफ डिनोमिनेटर
yes, छोटा
तो फोर्स ज्यादा होएगा F2 क्या कम होएगा डिनोमिनेटर छोटा तो आंसर मोटा ना
Yes, sir.
So that means on small pedal, he applies force F1. It goes to the wheel, jiska area jada. So jada force bed jata hai wo area pe. That's why it can be stopped. He applies force on pedal of smaller area. And it goes to the wheel, which is of larger area. So ye force F2 jada baithega iske upar. So vehicle will come to rest. Barabar na?
Yes, sir.
So this is one of the use is used in hydraulic press, hydraulic lift. So this type of principle is used in generally hydraulic machine. So Pascal's law over pressure acting over one application, hydraulic machine over. Then I completed for you. What is... viscosity, Newton's formula for viscosity, then coefficient of viscosity. After that, we did what is Stokes' law, its theoretical dimensions result. Then we did
terminal velocity.
Terminal velocity that completed our now two parts.
Sir, Reynolds number.
Reynolds number, streamline flow, turbulent flow. And the third part of chapter I am doing, Bernoulli's principle. Right, state and थोड़ा बड़ा चैप्टर है ये state and explain Bernoulli's principle whichever college will teach this chapter Bernoulli's principle पे again definitely they will ask you the question state and explain Bernoulli's principle State and explain Bernoulli's principle. Heading written?
Yes, sir.
What is equation of continuity? Are you remembering? A1 V1 equals to A2 V2. Correct, na?
Yes, sir.
So suppose this is one pipe. Liquid is entering at one end. And it is about to leave from other end. Is the height same or different?
So the heights are different.
Heights are different. So due to change in height, there will be potential energy?
Yes.
And because it is in motion, there is kinetic energy?
Yes, sir.
And liquid ke paas pressure hota hai. So energy due to pressure bhi aayega. So Bernoulli ne kuch bada baat nahi kiya. Usne bola, the sum for non-viscous incompressible for non-viscous incompressible streamline flow of fluid the sum of pressure energy sum of pressure energy kinetic energy ek minute pressure energy ka meaning samjha deta hu pressure means force upon area so can I say force is pressure into area work done is force into displacement so pa into displacement what is a into ds a into dx is what a into dx matlab area
इनटू डिस्टेंस कवर्ड, ये क्या चीज होता है? एरिया इनटू डिस्टेंस, इज इट वॉल्यूम?
यस सर।
सो पी इनटू वॉल्यूम, इसको मैं अगर वॉल्यूम से डिवाइड कर दो तो वीवी कैंसिल हो जाएगा ना?
यस सर।
तो इसको हम लोग बोलते हैं प्रेशर एनर्जी पर यूनिट वॉल्यूम। प्रेशर एनर्जी मतलब एनर्जी ड्यू टू फोर्स ऑफ लिक्विड। तो बर्नौली सेड फॉर नॉन विस्कस इनकॉम्प्रेसिबल स्ट्रीमलाइन फ्लो ऑफ फ्लूइड द सम ऑफ प्रेशर एनर्जी पर यूनिट वॉल्यूम कॉमा काइनेटिक एनर्जी पर यूनिट वॉल्यूम कॉमा पोटेंशियल एनर्जी पर यूनिट वॉल्यूम इज ऑलवेज कॉन्स्टेंट। ओके, स्टेटमेंट क्लियर?
यस सर।
यस सर।
सम ऑफ प्रेशर एनर्जी पर यूनिट वॉल्यूम कॉमा काइनेटिक एनर्जी पर यूनिट वॉल्यूम कॉमा पोटेंशियल एनर्जी पर यूनिट वॉल्यूम ऑलवेज रिमेन्स कॉन्स्टेंट, राइट? अकॉर्डिंग टू बर्नौली प्रिंसिपल, फॉर नॉन विस्कस कॉमा इनकॉम्प्रेसिबल non-viscous incompressible streamline flow of fluid the sum of pressure energy per unit volume कॉमा काइनेटिक एनर्जी पर यूनिट वॉल्यूम कॉमा पोटेंशियल एनर्जी पर यूनिट वॉल्यूम ऑलवेज रिमेन्स कॉन्स्टेंट। काइनेटिक एनर्जी पर यूनिट वॉल्यूम पोटेंशियल एनर्जी पर यूनिट वॉल्यूम ऑलवेज रिमेन्स कॉन्स्टेंट, दैट इज वेट वन मिनट जस्ट राइट फॉर्मूला देन आई विल एक्सप्लेन हाउ आई गॉट P plus half rho v square plus rho g h equals to constant. P plus half rho v square plus rho g h equals to constant. Once you are done, please tell so that I can clear.
डन फुल
यस सर
नाउ व्हाट हाउ वी गॉट दिस फॉर्मूला लेट अस चेक प्रेशर एनर्जी तो ऑलरेडी आई एक्सप्लेन बिकॉज प्रेशर इज फोर्स अपॉन एरिया therefore force is pressure into area energy means work done so I am multiplying by dx both side this is nothing but energy due to pressure or work done a dx means volume if I divide both side by volume then energy per unit volume due to pressure we are getting p what is kinetic energy ka formula is it half mv square
yes sir
if I divide by volume both side then mass upon volume it is density
yes sir.
So half rho v square is density we get second term potential energy means mgh divide by volume will become rho gh clear hello
yes sir
that is the reason why we wrote p plus half rho v square plus rho gh equals to constant this is known as Bernoulli's principle I hope you followed now
yes
now note write down note first point Bernoulli's principle is based on law of conservation of energy Bernoulli's principle is based on law of conservation of energy right first point Second point, since P plus half rho V square plus rho GH equals to constant, dividing throughout by rho G, rho and G both are constant, okay? So constant upon rho g will remain constant. Are you understanding why?
Yes, sir.
Because the constant upon rho g is constant only. So p upon rho g plus half v square upon g, rho rho will get cancelled, plus only h equals to constant. Now this three term has got some name. P upon rho g is called as pressure head v square upon 2g is called as velocity head and h is called as gravitational head right three for this name write two points properly p upon rho g is pressure head half v square by g is called velocity head and h is called gravitational head.
रिटर्न ओके कंप्लीटेड
यस सर डन
वन मोर नोट देन न्यू टॉपिक में सब टॉपिक सो सिंस पी प्लस हाफ रो वी स्क्वायर प्लस रो जी एच इक्वल्स टू कॉन्स्टेंट इफ पी वी इज कॉन्स्टेंट Then can I say P1 V1 is P2 V2? If you have done in chemistry?
Yes, sir.
So that means if this is constant, so I can say P1 plus half rho V1 square rho GH1 equals to P2 plus half rho V2 square. Plus rho g h2 we can na? Like we write pv constant then I say p1 v1 is p2 v2 so similarly here I can say p1 plus half rho v1 square plus rho g h1 equals to p2 plus half rho v2 square plus rho g h2 rho is constant because it is incompressible fluid if h1 is same as h2 can we cancel that
yes sir.
So P1 minus P2 is half rho V2 square minus half rho V1 square. That means at same height, P1 minus P2 will be half of rho V2 square minus V1 square. Very, very important formula to solve the numerical where they say decrease in pressure and increase in velocity happens. Right, third point, pressure decreases, velocity is increasing. Done?
Yes, sir.
चलो एक अच्छा थियरी करता हूं वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर एग्जाम अगेन इफ कॉलेज इज डन स्टेट एंड प्रूव टॉरी सेलीज प्रिंसिपल
state and prove Torricelli's principle. Vaibhav? Hello, Vaibhav?
Yes, sir.
If a body is dropped from height h, what will be the velocity acquired at the bottom? If a body is dropped,
sir,
what will be velocity acquired at bottom?
Sir, kinetic energy.
Nay, formula. What will be its value? Root of
2 root 2 gh. Gh.
This formula v square equal to u square plus 2s. Use karo. Drop matlab v is 0. 2gh. V is root 2gh. So Torricelli said that if there is opening in a container at height h from the free surface of liquid, then the liquid which will come out from this will have velocity 2gh wala, root 2gh. Abhi isko main jara acha English mein bolta hu. According to Torricelli's principle, the velocity of efflux, efflux matlab ye small opening through which stream of liquid is coming, velocity of efflux through an orifice matlab small opening, according to Torricelli's principle, velocity of efflux through an orifice is always equal to velocity acquired by the body falling freely under gravity from same height. Matlab mujhe prove karna hai, if this orifice matlab small opening is at height h, to usme se jo liquid niklega uska velocity root 2gh hai. Isliye likha hai state and proof. Again once again, heading you have written state and proof.
Yes,
sir. Statement I am repeating. Harshita, can you tell statement? The velocity of efflux through an orifice is always equal to the velocity acquired by body falling freely due to gravity from same height. So if body is falling freely from height h, we know formula is root 2gh. So I should prove that velocity of efflux through an orifice is always equal to velocity acquired by body falling freely due to gravity from same height. Just write statement. Statement meaning everybody has followed?
Yes, sir.
Please copy.
Done, sir.
Okay. Now we'll prove whether it is really true or not by using Bernoulli's principle. This is container, small opening. Liquid is taken in a container. At height h, there is small opening. At height h from the free surface of liquid. From here, liquid is coming out. We want to prove velocity of this liquid is root of 2gh. So this is surface. I am taking as A position. This is B position. Consider liquid of density rho. Consider liquid of density rho to be taken in a container having orifice, that means small opening, at height h from free surface of liquid. Let V be the velocity of liquid through orifice. Please draw the diagram and copy this much.
Can you repeat the last line?
Last line, using Bernoulli's principle, at surface and opening we get. Shall I clear everything now and use that Bernoulli's principle at opening and surface? Okay, just see. Surface means A and opening means B. At A, atmospheric pressure PA is acting plus, hello, what is height at A? H at A, rho G plus half rho VA square is P at B plus height at B, rho g plus half velocity at B square. Now at A, pressure acting is atmospheric pressure. Hello?
Yes, sir.
And height at A of the liquid is zero.
Yes, sir.
See, I'm talking about from this, A is our, A and B are the two points. So h is the height from that orifice at A, correct? A reference, B से हम height माप रहे हैं from the surface, तो गलती से zero मत कर देना, and velocity at A is zero plus हो गया एकदम इक्वल्स टू प्रेशर एट बी इज ऑल्सो एटमोस्फेरिक बिकॉज ओरिफाइस इज ओपन टू द एटमोस्फियर हाइट फ्रॉम द ओरिफाइस इज जीरो ऑफ द लिक्विड रो जी प्लस हाफ रो into velocity at B is V. Now PA PA can you cancel? So
yes.
V this will become zero. It's half rho into V square. Rho rho cancel. So 2GH equal to V square. Therefore velocity is root of 2GH. Then it's proved or not? This proves Torricelli's principle. Any doubt in your mind?
No.
Please write down poll. So velocity acquired is root 2gh is same as velocity of free falling body from height h.
Done, sir.
Till end you have completed?
Yes, sir.
So that's all for
today. Sir.
Achha, everybody complete that. Friday I will be able to complete this chapter, ka third part. Sunday's test ka topic, you all are aware?
Yes.
What is the topic for test?
The gravitation and elasticity.
Yes, elasticity plus gravitation. Correct.
Done, sir.
So that's all for today. Please revise and be yourself comfortable in next class. If you want revision of or